Hi and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a review of 4 coats that I own from The Curated. I've actually had a number of requests to do this review, so hopefully it's going to be really helpful for those of you who are curious about sizing and just want to know a little bit more about the quality of these coats and also just general wear and tear. Now, for full disclosure, all of these coats were gifted to me, but honestly, I never really let that color my opinion of something, and I'm always very real with you about what I think. And I'm gonna kind of talk to the pros and cons of each style, or just little elements and things like that, which I hope will be really helpful for those of you who are really trying to make a discerning choice. Now, I did get all of these coats in a size small, and I am a standard Australian size 8 or US 4, and I am 172 centimeters tall. I wanted to briefly touch on the ethos of the brand too. The founder, Nicola, her intent behind The Curated was to design classic, timeless pieces that you'll be able to wear for many, many years, which are also well made, so they're built to last. A lot of their practices through manufacturing are also sustainable and ethical. There's a lot more information about it on their website, and they don't have that same markup on their items as other brands might, so it allows you to get that little bit of luxury for a much more affordable price. So I kind of want to start with, I think, where it all really began for the brand, the classic coat. I think this is probably the one that I get the most questions about. I have it here in the camel, and as mentioned, it's in a size small. It's very much just your classic robe coat. It has the large patch pockets on the front, the folded over lapel. Like all their other coats, it is double faced, which means that it is unlined. The composition of the fabric is 70% wool and 30% cashmere, so you have that luxury component in there. And as we all know, cashmere is just unbelievably soft, and it really does play such an important role in how this fabric feels against your hand. It has a really lovely soft sort of a brushed wool texture to it, which is very nice, and it feels very luxurious. It feels like quality. I actually did own the first iteration of this coat, and I have to say there's a huge improvement between the first version and this one. This just feels like a step above, and you can really see that Nicola's putting a lot of work into ensuring that her customers are getting the best quality. Now, you could probably see just from me holding it up that it doesn't have a belt, or it doesn't have belt loops on it. It does actually come with a matching belt, which I am going to show you in the cutaways. And for me, you know, I do wish it had belt loops. This is probably my only bugbear with these coats, is that they don't have the belt loops attached, which means that you either need to carry the belt around in the pocket, which actually does look quite bulky because I've tried that, or you need to carry it around in your bag, and that assumes that you have enough room in your bag to actually have the belt in there. There's this little fabric loop here at the back. I suppose you could loop it around there, but then that would be a little bit uncomfortable having the belt lying against your back as you're sitting down. So that's probably my biggest bugbear about it. In terms of this particular shape, this is a very slim cut coat. So I find if I'm wearing a really bulky knit sweater, it isn't going to comfortably fit underneath this because it does come quite high up underneath the arms, and it isn't as wide through the arm as some of their other styles that they have. So something to keep in mind if you are looking at this coat, if you do like a really, really big oversized chunky knit, then it may not work underneath this, or it may feel a little bit on the restrictive side. Overall, I really like this style. However, I don't find myself reaching for it quite as much just because I do tend to wear bigger knits in the colder months, but the color is really beautiful. The camel is just a very, very classic hue, very kind of neutral with a very, very slight warm undertone. Okay, so the second coat that I've got here is called the boyfriend coat, and I have this one in the charcoal, again in the size small. You can see the belt here, I've got it looped around the coat hanger. I tend to wear this mostly open, and out of all of the styles I have from The Curated, this is actually the one that I wear the most, and I think this is shaped up to kind of be my most worn coat of the winter, just because it goes with everything and it works really well over those more oversized knits, which I think is part of the reason why I've gravitated towards this so much. Even if you're wearing a blazer, that also fits quite nicely underneath this. So whereas the classic coat, I would say, has a bit more of a slimmer profile, the boyfriend coat is much more oversized. There's a lot more fabric across the body. It does have very similar details otherwise, if you kind of look at them side by side. It has the same patch pockets, but there's a little bit more length through the body, and then yeah, it's just wider everywhere. The underarm has a bit more give to it, a bit more ease. It just feels a lot more relaxed, and to me this has a very Scandinavian vibe, whereas I would say that Classic Coat feels a little bit more Parisian from that perspective. Again, it's that beautiful double face wool, and it is the same composition as the Classic Coat, 70% wool and 30% cashmere. So it feels really, really nice in your hands. This is not itchy at all against your skin. And I'm saying this as someone who does have mildly sensitive skin, so I don't really like to wear anything that is going to irritate me, but this I can wear against my bare skin and I am very, very happy. So that is the Boyfriend Coat. As someone who's really leaning into those relaxed silhouettes at the moment, the Boyfriend Coat for that reason is my number one. It gets a big tick from me. However, if you tend to prefer a slightly slimmer silhouette or something that is a bit more classic in terms of the shape, then I would say go with the Classic. Third coat that I've got here is called the Graduate Coat, which I have in the Bone, or I believe it's now called Cream. The color of this has a slightly pink undertone to it, which I think is actually very visible when you compare it to this crisp white top that I'm wearing. I actually hadn't really anticipated how cool toned it was going to be until it arrived, and for that reason I actually find it a little bit more challenging to wear, but I'll get into that in a minute. So this, unlike the other styles, it's actually double breasted and it does have buttons. It fastens over to the left, and it does also have that button on the inside, and you can see here that the buttons have been reinforced. So this is a telltale sign of quality. When you look at a coat and it does also have a button on the reverse, you know that they are going to be fastened on much more securely, which I really like. The pockets on this are a slip pocket, so they don't have that patch detail, and I really like this effect here where you've got the banded section. I always feel like that looks very, very chic. The fit through the shoulders and the body is actually very similar to the Classic, though I do kind of feel like this one does fit slightly wider across the body, or at least you've got a little bit more room around the waist than with the Classic. Again, no belt loops on this coat either, so you can see I've actually got the belt tucked into the pocket, but it does make it kind of bulky, and hopefully you can kind of see there's this little bulky section here. So that, again, I do just wish that there were belt loops on here, and I understand the reason why there aren't. It's because depending on your height, your natural waist is going to sit at a different point. So if you're petite, your natural waist is going to sit slightly higher up on the coat than it would for someone who is taller or has a longer torso. So depending on where you put those belt loops, it can either look really great on someone or really bad if it doesn't match with their physique and their build. So by not having the loops, not only do you create a really nice seamless finish down the sides, but you also avoid coming into that issue. Personally, I just prefer for there to be belt loops at a standard point, but that's just my preference because I always worry about losing these belts, and I swear I actually had thought I had misplaced the camel one. So as I mentioned, the color is cool tone, and I do sort of wish that I selected a different color, maybe even the black, because that is classic, but I do kind of feel like the color plays off really nicely with the tortoise shell buttons, which have a matte effect. So again, double faced wool, and this one actually is a slightly different composition to the other coats. It is 90% wool and 10% cashmere. So this actually feels really, really soft. However, it doesn't feel as soft as the other two. It's a very, very small margin, and honestly I think if you didn't have them here to compare you wouldn't really know the difference, but something I did just want to mention. I'm not sure if they've changed the composition since I got this coat, which was last year, but yeah, something I thought I would mention. But honestly, you really, really can very barely tell the difference, and again, the quality is very nice. It's held up very, very well. I wore mine quite a bit, and there's absolutely zero pilling. And actually, that's something to mention about the other two coats too, is I don't have a single bit of pilling to them, and being this sort of brushed wool, it does mean that if you get any marks or any sort of dirt marks on there, you can get a brush, like a soup brush, and you can just brush that off, which makes it very easy to care for. I would recommend dry cleaning once a season. Final coat that I've got is a down puffer coat, and I really like this sort of style for kind of bundling up when it is cold, when it is very cold in the winter. So I have the long, this is, I believe it's called the Modern Down Coat. It's very, very long. It has a water resistant cotton finish on the exterior, so it means if you do get caught in the rain, you're not going to get completely soaked through, which is very nice. And it has this kind of like puffy fold over collar detail. I've seen other brands do similar styles to this, like Totem, and I saw a few at Arquette as well over autumn winter. I'll link some other alternatives below. But it's really cool. Did you hear that? That is actually the magnet. So it's got a magnet closure, which is really neat. I've never ever seen anything like that before. This has been made with 90% ethical down, which I suspect is probably recycled down feathers. And yeah, you can see it's fully lined with cotton on the inside as well, but very kind of like plush feeling, and it is incredibly warm. I have worn this a few times when it has been really cold here in Sydney, at least by my standards, and I've been kept nice and warm and toasty on my walks. I do have those same magnetic closures on the pockets too. Probably my biggest complaint with this one is the fact that the fabric, it tends to pick up fluff a bit. Now, we have a ragdoll cat. I kind of bring this up a lot when I'm talking about black items in my closet, and he sheds fur quite a bit, and so getting those little fine white particles on things, it can make that item feel slightly high maintenance. So you need to make sure you've got some sort of a lint brush or a lint roller so that you can keep it looking really nice and tidy. But otherwise, I mean, yeah, the quality of this is exceptional. Again, really what I have come to expect from the curated, and overall I really, really love it. And it's a sort of style that I think, again, is very timeless and that you would be happy to wear season on season. I will also insert a little photo of me wearing this one too, but it looks really chic worn open as well. Now, this section of the video, I am going to have a side by side of all four coats so that you can really get a sense of how they fit on me and what they look like compared to each other, just in case that is sort of like the final deal breaker if you're sort of in between styles. For me, as I keep saying, the one that I come back to time and time again is the boyfriend coat. This is by far my favorite because I just love that relaxed, easy look. It feels very chic, very effortless, and I sort of feel like I've been transported to Scandinavia even though I'm still at home. But yeah, that is sort of my little mini review of the curated coats. I hope that you found this little try on helpful. I will have all of the items that I shared today linked down in the description box below, along with all the pieces I styled them with in the cutaways. I hope that gave you a better look at how they fit on me. Quite often I get asked the question, should I size up or size down? And really, I think that just comes down to how you want an item to fit on you. So I think I would just recommend being very, very careful with your selection. Obviously, if you love the camel but you prefer the fit of the boyfriend, then you can get the boyfriend in a camel color. It does come in multiple options, so that's always really nifty. Otherwise, you could just size up if you want a little bit of extra room. So that is it from me today. I hope that you found this quick little video helpful, especially if you have been eyeing up one of these coats. And if you do have any other questions, just let me know in the comment section below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you for spending some of your day with me, and I will see you soon. Bye.